Hello and welcome to another video about putting lights in model trains, one of my little railway tutorials. In this video I'm going to look at how you put lights in the Lima Mk3 coaches. Now these were models that came out during the 80s and they kept producing them into the 90s. Popular ones, though. There were sleepers, there were first class coaches, second class coaches, and these buffet cars. This is a buffet car for an Intercity 125, and over here is a sleeper car in executive livery. Now, when these first came out, the detail was quite good. Of course, the earlier models, the gangway ends weren't particularly detailed at all. Although this later improved, where you got things like the tops codes panels and the C3s and the overhead warning lights and the nice little bit of yellow paint, which acted as a warning on British Railways tracks. But I'm not really sort of sweating it on these Lima Mk3s to put lots more detail into the trains, because they are old models, and the new Hornby Mk3s are probably quite a lot better. Interestingly, the tooling for the coach and for the roof sections and the end sections is pretty much the same on the Lima and the Hornby models, because Hornby bought the old Lima toolings. They're quite tricky coaches to get apart. I think the thing that you've got to do with these coaches is you have to sort of prise up the little gangway ends off the model, and then apply pressure to the end windows on the vehicles, and then gradually take the glass out. This was all quite easy to do on the buffet model. However, the sleeper models, the plastic used for the glazing, seemed to be a bit more brittle. Unfortunately, it did crack at the ends, and a little bit of plastic came out on both sides. Not only that, on the sleeper, the actual glass around the windows broke a little bit. I don't know whether this will actually be visible when I try to reassemble it. Although this coach was one that I bought second hand, it had already sort of been through the mill a bit. There's a big crack in the bottom, so yeah, it's an old model. Something about the Lima Mk3s is that initially they had plastic wheels. Now, on the buffet car, I decided to replace these wheels, which were slightly less wide than the wheels used on the Hornby bogies, on the sort of revitalised Hornby version of the Mk3. So these wheels on this coach were originally plastic. Not particularly nice wheels, a bit clunky. So I replaced them with these wheels from Peter's Spares, which I believe originated in China. Now, as you can see, there's paint on half of the axle. This paint is actually a electroconductive paint, and I've applied it to one side of the axle so that power comes from one side of the track only, on each end of the vehicle. As you can see, on the other end, it comes from the other side of the track, so that there's effectively a pickup on either side of the coach for, you know, positive and minus coming through from the DC supply on the track. This method should also work, that I'm employing, should also work on DCC tracks which have an AC supply, because the way that I'm wiring it also works with DCC. Now, I'm going to use LEDs to light this coach. in order to install these, I'm using these DIY light store units. There's one there, it hasn't been soldered yet. This should fit in the buffet kitchen area, or equally, that should fit okay within the sleeping section of the coach, which is a bit rudimentary. Lima's depiction of that. There's no interior for the coach. I sort of toyed with the idea of making interiors for the two executive livery sleeper coaches that I've got, but actually I think it's probably too much effort. I'm sort of more using N-gauge and Z-gauge models now, and this is just a little fun project that I've got going to install lights in some of my 00 trains. Some of them I'm detailing a little bit more, like I've got some Hornby swoosh liveried ScotRail sleepers. So really, installing the lights in this sleeper, it's a bit of a dry run for my Hornby sleeper, which uses the same tooling. So that's the wheels and the actual coaches. Here, this is one of the original. This is one of the later Lima wheel sets, which Lima did go on to metal. In the end, they weren't always plastic. They did move on to metal by the time they started making these executive liveried models. However, I think that the wheels from Peter's Spares, which came in at about, I think it was about £3 a wheel set, or, well, £3 a bogey or something, off eBay, seem to be a much nicer plastic. Sorry, a much nicer metal. They've got a nice bit of a gleam to them and look more like the real thing. So I think I'm going to install these on all of the Lima Mk3 coaches. As you can see with the buffet car, something else I've done is that I've added some cheap 00 people, which I bought from a seller in China, I believe, for not much money. I think it was maybe £1.40 for 100 of them. And I've sort of sat them down in the seats and stood a few at the buffet queue. They're stuck down with copy decks, which doesn't attack the plastic, which can be peeled off because it's kind of a rubber solution, because I don't want to damage the original model too much. So I'll just put that back in there. So yeah, this video I'll show you how I wire up the pickups and feed the wires through into the buffet car area on this coach. I'm going to be concentrating on this coach because I can't be bothered to make a video for all these Lima coaches. They're pretty much wired up and lit in exactly the same way. Something that I have done is with this roof section for the buffet car, I've put some white insulating electrical tape along the windows of the kitchen, because these windows are frosted in real life and you wouldn't be actually looking in there. Plus, I'm going to have the DIY light store unit in the buffet area, and I don't really want to be looking at that because it's a bit of an ugly contraption. Something else I've done on one end of the coach, I put another little piece of sparky tape in the window to represent the frosted glass of the toilet compartment. Another thing I've done is put some silver tape along the inside of the roof. Now, as you can appreciate, the Lima Mk 3s use an integral piece of plastic for both the windows and the roof, and this is spray painted black, spray painted in the Lima factory. It all fits together very well. there's no gaps visible once the coach is put together. In fact, it's very difficult to see how to take it apart. But one disadvantage of this is that the paint on top of the coach isn't particularly lightproof. Now, I got some sticky tape. There it is. Off eBay, I think that was about £2 a roll. I got quite a lot of it. That sticky tape is essentially just foil with a sticky back. Not sticky back plastic like on Blue Peter, but sticky back foil. You can get it. And I've used this foil to line the inside of the roof of the vehicle so that it's lightproof. Light can't get through that. You can put some LEDs on. Light doesn't get through. So it's really good. Something else that I'm going to do, I'm going to put a piece of this, which is self-adhesive paper, bought from eBay, I think, for about £1, for about 6 sheets of this, used for making sticky labels. I'm going to stick that over the top of the silver foil so that the roof is a nice matte white, like it would be, I suppose, on a real coach. Because you don't get silver interiors on intercity coaches. I've not bothered to repaint the inside of the coach. I think the orange buffet area is probably quite accurate. I seem to remember it being very orange at that end of the coach. However, I think the seats were a bit more yellow in the first class or restaurant area of Intercity 125s. But I've not bothered to repaint them because I just can't spend time creating interiors on all of these 00 coaches. So that gives you an idea of what I'm going to do with the coaches. I suppose the next step is going to be installing the paper and soldering together this little light store unit. Before I start doing those tasks, one little point I thought I'd mention is the lights that I'm going to use on this coach. They're these LEDs, light emitting diodes. They light up in one direction only normally, using these wires which are soldered onto the little, where shall I find them? Onto these little brass contacts on the strip. Now, these when you power them off a DC track, they'll light up in one direction. However, using a bridge rectifier, which is this thing, you can take power so that it only goes in one direction regardless of what direction the power is going on the track. This also works if you plug it into a track that has an AC supply, maybe some kind of DCC, use this sort of thing, so that these will still work on a DCC track. The other terminals on this bridge rectifier put out a DC supply. They're connected to a 4,700 microfarad capacitor. This will store power for the coach, for the lighting for the coach. Meaning that when you go over points, or if you stop in a station for a couple of seconds, the lights will stay on, which is a great improvement on older forms of coach lighting. There are people on the internet that produce these kinds of light store devices. I think they use smaller supercapacitors. However, we've got quite a bit of space in this buffet compartment, so I'm going to use this nice big old capacitor. As for cost, how much does it cost? These capacitors cost about £1, and the other components, the bridge rectifier and here, a potentiometer to dim the lighting to an appropriate level, cost about 40p each, so that's about £1.40. These LEDs come on strips that of 5 meters in length for about £4.60. So you're looking at about, for a coach of this length, you know, 20 something pence for it, maybe 20 pence. So that and that together, that's what about 160. The other things I've got, you know, this, if you don't have a roll of this stuff, that costs about £1, the foil tape, the other things cost about £1, so you're probably looking at something like £2 per coach maximum, which is a lot cheaper than using ready done light store units, which can cost anything up to about £14 per coach. Of course, the silver conductive paint is quite expensive. I think it's £7 for a little container of it. I'll just go and get one so I can show you the silver conductive paint, which is called chemo, and it is quite noxious stuff. You have to shake it up a bit each time you use it. It separates very quickly because it's just particles of silver in suspension, I believe. So that's the paint, and that'll probably do about 10 coaches. So £7 for about 10 coaches, about 70p a coach. Add that to maybe, I don't know, £2.70 per coach. It's still pretty cheap. And this is the coach with the self-adhesive paper installed along the roof. It's quite difficult to get it lined up. I might put another little thin strip down that side just to cover over the silver at that side, so that it's all covered. This is just a little clip to show you what the buffet car looks like with the lights installed. What I did with this was I actually cut the lighting strip, the LED strip, into two pieces because I put the light store unit in the kitchen section of the buffet car. And then put a little strip for this bit here and a little strip for this bit here. So all the gubbins for the light store unit is stored in the middle of the coach. The wires, that's just losing a bit of powder, the wires for this coach, it sort of comes up through the floor. There, the wire from the bogey. I drilled a tiny little hole in the top of where the clip is, a little plastic clip that holds the bogey onto the bottom of the chassis. That little wire comes through there and then runs to the side of the coach and then down a little ducket underneath all the seats to the kitchen area. Whereas at the other end, the wire coming from this bogey goes up through the bar along the bottom of the bar, which is kind of in a little recess, and into the kitchen area. So I managed to put the wires quite unobtrusively out of the way. This is running on a 12 volt supply. As you can see, it's not overly bright, and you can see the people in there enjoying their meals, maybe a ticket inspector. It all looks quite homely, really. This end's quite orange, as the Intercity 125s were in the early days, this end of the buffet car, and I think that actually looks quite good. I'll just show you the underside of the coach. As I lift it up, you'll notice that the lights will stay on because this is using a capacitor. See, they're gradually dimming now. They'll gradually dim back to nothing. There's the other side. This is what the pickups look like that I constructed for this coach. They're quite simple, really. See the wheels have got the light conductive paint on at one side, so that one side is insulated. Then I've got a very thin strip which is soldered to a little rectangle of brass. Then I've got a wire that comes down through the brass strip that is soldered onto the underside. That's what this glob of solder is. That's the wire, soldered on quite well. And then two little screws either side to screw all this onto the bogey of the coach, which is sort of tucked out the way. You can't see it at a track level. I might actually put some black paint over this at some point, just to make it a little bit more inobtrusive, but not on the pickup strip. I think that looks quite good. I'll just put the train back on so you can see what the other side of the coach looks like. Not quite on the track there. There you go, that's the other side of it. That's the kitchen side of it. Something that I did do was I used on the back of the kitchen, because these windows were kind of frosted in real life, I used some white insulation tape, just so that when you look into the coach you don't see the DIY light store unit. I think that's quite good. I'll probably show at some point the same process of lighting a sleeper coach, a Mk3 sleeper coach, which I'm going to repeat this process on that, so I can show you how I put together the contacts in a little bit more detail.